another question. You see, usually when you approach boutiques, they want to know, like for example, if I go with this one piece, they want to know what are the other colors that you have, what else you have. They want to know the stock that you have. Now for someone like me who's just starting out, I cannot really keep extra stock, I cannot invest my money in that right now because I don't know if the boutique is actually going to give me that order or not. And there's like a whole process to it. So how can we handle that?
I think it's very, very hard, you know, and I can tell you myself because I've sort of been there and done that, you know, and I know what you're saying. It's like, you know, if you don't have your own boutique, then obviously to have all of your array of colours and have all, you know, your samples and everything made up and ready and, you know, there for presentation, obviously it's very costly for a start, it's very difficult. I really sympathise, you know. Starting out is the hardest, but you have to kind of like, preparation is key for that reason, because if you're not professional when you go to, you know, one of the stores in Dubai Mall or this is the Carbinex or anywhere else, if you're not professional from the first, you know, meeting that you have, then the chances are that they probably won't see you again after that. So even if you have to take a bit more time and just sort of, you know, think, right, let me have another couple of weeks or whatever, get your presentation really set out, and you know, just swatches, even if you have swatches, along with your images, you know, it's like they would accept that, they would understand that. But you just sort of, you need to, have all of the components ready so that obviously if they do want to take it on and order, you know, you've got everything there to say, right, well actually, yes, we'll have it in pink, green and yellow, you know, because they can envisage how it looks because you've got one sample. So, you know, just sort of take time, do the preparation, and then afterwards it will pay off all the work, you know?
Just want to add, in the beginning, boutiques are usually looking for exclusivity. So that's an issue.
Sorry, we can't hear.
I think it's gone off.
I think you should hold the microphone here.
No.
It keeps going on and off.
Is it? Okay. So the issue you face is many boutiques will ask for exclusivity, and it depends on you, how you want to position the brand. So it's very important to first identify who's your customer, where do they shop at, which boutiques you're after. If they want exclusivity, don't expect to make money for a while. So what you're looking at is first positioning the brand at a certain level, and then you expand. They're very picky on quality, so it's okay to invest in the beginning in the best of the best, because this is the name of your brand. You will invest a lot, let me tell you, don't expect to make a lot back for a while, but it's worth it because you're building up something big. Also, what you do is you create the samples. Once you showcase them, they'll pick a few orders in the swatches that you have available. So I would recommend don't approach manufacturers because minimum quantity are usually, if you're lucky, 150 per style, per color. So if I were you, I would find a manufacturer that can do no minimum quantity and just start really small. Even if have 5 pieces of Harvey Nichols, your name is still at somewhere really good. But lots of the customers we've lost in the past because they wanted that exclusivity part. And it's very hard in certain markets like Saudi or Dubai where you want to be at a lot of boutiques.
Yes, so.
Thank you, Amna, for your presentation and the panelists for the response.